I do a lot of walking and observing, especially nature, and I find that I get lost a lot when I go for hikes. Usually, during those unexpected turns, I'm really delighted in what I find. And that really has informed my work quite a bit, so that my work is a lot about sort of navigation, trying to kind of find my way out of chaos. I do a lot of drawings and sketches and observation, and then I take that and try to just sort of abstract from it even more and use my imagination. And one mark leads to the next one. My name is Abby Goldstein. I am an artist resident for 2021 at the Sam and Adele Golden Foundation for the Arts. I'm always inspired by where I'm at, and it's one of the reasons I like going to residencies. I really came here to experiment and kind of let in whatever came my way. I love materials. I used R&F paint sticks for a long time and Williamsburg paint. I think that's probably one of the most amazing opportunities has been to work with the technical support and who are also artists. Their just willingness and openness to talk about materials, their process, and how to use the material for your purposes has been pretty amazing. I think it's rare how much the company and people behind it care, you know, about the artists and care about the environment and world and development of materials. Enormous generosity is kind of overwhelming. To be able to have all the material at your fingertips is pretty extraordinary.
What I've loved about the barn and this space in particular is all the windows. And so I went with that and took a lot of information compositionally from the light streaming in. So all these paintings were started here. Like these are clementines, for instance, and this is coming from some plants. But everything else sort of was informed by the light around the residency. Something I'm really excited about, I think, with this collection is grouping them in pairs and really sort of having two paintings speak to one another in terms of formal composition, but also sort of sentiment too. And then when in doubt, I put a paint blob or a paint stripe on it, or I do a fun mark because at the end of the day it's paint and it's fun and I don't want them to take themselves too seriously. I am Claire Stankus and I am a resident at the Sam and Adele Golden Foundation for the Arts. The first technical we went to was all about grounds and pastes, and it was a really great experience to get hands-on feel for the products, knowing that each product has a specific function and a purpose, and there's lots of benefits to each one. To just know what everything does and how it works and really how to best use that opportunity. But after it was over, I knew I needed to see it on paper. I needed to see it on canvas to see how they interacted with the paints I was using and also the drawing materials and watercolor.
So I did basically a test of all the grounds. And then with acrylic and oil, watercolor, color pencil, oil pastel, Sharpie as undertones, and then over them as well. So really coming here and experimenting and then being able to pass that information on.
Coming here, I wanted to work big. I love scaling up. There are times I will use my own images, taking my own photography, and then go in and paint on the top. I will embed things into the photos, do a little bit of a collage.
So what you're looking at is my photograph below, and then there is text on the top, and the text is an actual immigration pass for my maternal grandmother when she left India and came to Trinidad. It was in 1912.
My name is Renluka Maharaj, and I am a resident at the Sam and Adele Golden Foundation for the 2021 season. I wanted to create a skin and have images on the top of this skin. So I tried a whole bunch of different things, gels, different mediums, and I settled on the color pouring medium because of how thin it is. I think I'm very attracted to the transparency of the skins and the gels. So I started making these small intimate portraits, digitally printed images onto the skin.
Another reason I like the pouring medium is because I do get these funky shapes. I never know what's gonna happen, how it's gonna level out. The plastic gives it a lot of texture. So my first successful print, and then I got hooked. It's like the first time I did photography and I saw my image appear. I was like, oh my God, this is like amazing. And then when it happened with this, I was like, wow.
What have I gained that I will take with me when I leave this residency? More knowledge about materials, how to better preserve my prints, and that there are wonderful people in the world who want to help you succeed and create better work. And I think everyone I've met here has been incredible. I love that people like you exist. This has been such a gift.